वेलकम टू वी लर्न वर्चुअल लर्निंग नेटवर्क। दिस इज सेशन नंबर 12 ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट ऑर्गेनाइजिंग चाइल्ड केयर सर्विसेज एंड द चैप्टर कोग्निटिव डेवलपमेंट टूवर्ड्स मेंटल रिप्रेजेंटेशन एंड सिम्बॉलिक थिंकिंग। लेट्स सी द कंटेंट्स विच आर टू बी कवर्ड। इंट्रोडक्शन, थॉट इन द सेकेंड ईयर, सेंसरी मोटर पीरियड, सबस्टेज 5, सबस्टेज 6, pre-operational period. By the end of the first year, the infant's action and behavior become intentional. She or he is able to coordinate her actions for a purpose, that is, behavior becomes goal-directed. When an infant's actions, by the end of the first year, the infant's actions become goal-directed, means the infant starts to achieve something or to work for something. Here we'll read about the development of thought in the second and third year of life. How the development of thoughts of infants take place in the second and third year of life. Let's see that. Thought in the second year, sensory motor period. One of the major sources of data for Piaget as he was formulating his theory of cognitive development was his observations of his three children, Piaget. For him, the theory of cognitive development, he wanted to observe his three children, how they behaved, how was their psychology, and plus also then saying or formulating his theory based upon his observation of his three children. Substage 5, the fifth substage of the sensory motor period, lasts from 12 to 18 months. The child now experiments, he tries out different ways of doing things. He changes his actions. Now the child starts to experiment various things, and he or she also experiments different ways of doing different things. For example, when he or she plays, he finds out different ways of playing, various thoughts, how he can or how he or she can change a particular thing, and their actions as well, how a different way of doing different actions. Since toddlers modify their actions, they are able to explore the properties of objects. They are also able to explore the objects. They are able to explore the toys and the objects with which they are playing. So the properties of objects, whatever they are, they are able to explore, they are able to find out, and they are able to question also that this particular thing is happening or why is this happening. For example, as they drop different objects, they will notice that some bounce, some do not, and that some break. They also notice that some objects do not break, some objects bounce, some objects keep as it is. So, and some objects they are also able to kick. When you think of or observe a toddler, you'll find that he or she experiments as he or she kicks or throws objects, puts things in containers, pulls her toys, eats food and scribbles. In fact, experimentation is obvious in everything he or she does. So experimentation is obvious. The child tries to find out new ways of doing things, whether of pulling toys, eating food, putting things in containers, scribbling and kicking or throwing objects, holding the objects. So all these activities, the child finds out new things, new ways of performing various actions, whatever he or she does in regular life, that is different from that. The willingness and desire to try out new things makes it possible for the toddler to discover new ways of solving problems as well. In the later years of life as well, the more willingness, the more desire one has of solving problems or of trying out new things to solve problems, the more a person develops problem-solving skills in the later years of life. So in this stage, the child develops willingness and desire to try out different things and discover new ways of solving different small problems which he or she encounters in life. The ability to vary one's behavior and actions deliberately is a valuable tool in problem-solving, and we see the first signs of it in substage 5 of the sensory motor period. When the child is in the substage 5, then we see the various problem-solving skills which are also helpful and useful in the later years of life of the child. So that is quite visible in the behavior and the actions the child performs. Substage 6. Between 18 months and 2 years of age, a major shift in the child's manner of thinking occurs. This is the sixth substage of the sensory motor period of development. A major change of thinking also occurs. A major shift in the child's manner of thinking also occurs. The ability to form mental representation of events, of being able to picture events to oneself, is the hallmark of substage 6. The ability to form mental representations, mental pictures, and being able to picture events, and being also being aware that if a certain object is not there, it still is somewhere around, and that the child wants that particular object. And being able to think about that object or any toy or a person is the hallmark of this stage. Mental representation is involved in every task that we do, and the rudiments of this ability are evident towards the end of the sensory motor stage. So mental representation is involved in every task. The child is able to picture, the child is able to mentally represent, mentally visualize a particular object or any person, and the rudiments of this ability is evident in the sensory motor stage when the child tries to develop the organs. Being able to represent events mentally influences the child's imitation. So when the child is trying to represent various events in minds, that also helps, and that also influences the child's imitation, how the child behaves later. Imitation is one of the ways through which the child learns ways of behavior. Before the sixth substage, imitation immediately followed an action or a behavior. But now the toddler is able to delay the imitation over a considerable period of time. So imitation, when the child observes adults or the family members around, imitation is one of the way the child learns different ways of behavior. And the child also does in the similar way. Like the way the parent behaves or the parent acts, the child also tries to imitate them. Their action, their behavior, their facial expressions, or their way of saying things, the child also starts imitating them. By now, the toddler is able to delay the imitation over a considerable period of time. The toddler's understanding of cause and effect also improves during the sixth substage. How, why a particular thing happens, and if this happens, then what will happen? What effect will it have? The understanding of cause, why a particular thing happens, the reason, as well as the effect, the impact of a particular thing which it will have, also it improves during this stage. Towards the end of the sensory motor period, the beginnings of the make-believe can be seen in the child's play. Towards the end of the sensory motor period, the beginnings of the make-believe that if the particular object is not present in front of the child, but the child sees or the child believes that that object, if it is not there, but still it exists, that the traces of that can also be seen in the child's play, the way the child play. Pre-operational period. Once the child begins to picture events mentally and to use symbols, it marks the transition to the second stage of cognitive development, the pre-operational period. Because in that stage or in that period, the child is able to mentally see the pictures or the events around, and also he or she is able to use the symbols. So in this way, the cognitive development takes place, and it means the mind, the development of the mind takes place, the development of the brain takes place, and the child is able to see pictures and visualize pictures when he or she can close eyes as well. The pre-operational period extends from the second birthday to the sixth or seventh birthday. During this period, the child's motor skills diversify and her language also grows rapidly. So in this stage, the child's language grows, the child's language diversifies, the child learns new language, how to put sentences, it grows, as and also the motor skills diversify, the child's coordination between hands, between the body, between hands and legs, between the mind and hands, the coordination also and the motor skills develops as well as it diversifies. And it lasts, this particular stage lasts from the second birthday to the sixth or the seventh birthday, wherein the growth or the development of the child is rapid. So these are some of the questions. You have to do it yourself. First, explain the sub-stage 5 of sensory motor period. Question number 2, what is pre-operational period? That's all we have for you in this session. Thank you. Happy learning. We learning.